I think one of the most important problems that this whole country faces is the quality of life in their cities, in our cities. It's been my life's work. And here's a state that is growing. It's a young state. It's the youngest, and it's probably growing at the fastest rate. And it seems to me that if this state can't look down south and learn from the problems of the obsolescent cities that we've built in the rest of the U.S., then it's a terrible waste. So this is a fantastic opportunity for the state of Alaska to show the rest of the country that they can build a good contemporary American city under extraordinary conditions, difficult conditions, and yet do it well. That to me is of fundamental importance, and the possibility of doing it has evoked these fantastic schemes by all these professionals. They got up for it. Everybody should be up for it.
The Capital Site Planning Commission, a statewide group appointed by the governor, was created to plan, not advocate, the creation of a new capital city. They've been given 7 months and $1.7 million to accomplish that task.
Well, the mission of our commission is to make a plan that will demonstrate the desirability and perhaps as important clearly the feasibility of relocating the capital to the site at Willow. And we had to determine first of all how the government would move from Juneau to the Willow site. And that was only recently completed. And a lot in these schemes are conceptual drawings for the government center. And then we had also to figure out what life would be like in the new city after, during, and after the move is completed. And that's the social, cultural aspects of the new city.
Given the large scope of the project, is the timetable that you're forced to work under a feasible timetable?
Well, the timetable for making the plan is feasible, yes, but with, you know, fantastic energy has gone out. When you look at something like this, here we start with a blank piece of fiber foam plastic. That was given to these teams 1 month ago, and 30 days later they come back with a plan of a city, which is phenomenal. What these are all about is to illustrate the different environments, and the commission will pick the one that they think is most Alaskan.
Carving a new city out of wilderness is not easy. The commission chose 5 of the nation's leading architectural and planning firms to submit a basic design for the city. Heinrich Bull is from one of them. He says the idea of creating a new capital city isn't new, but that it isn't always successful either.
There have been 2 recent examples, both of which I think are horrible, Brasilia and Chandigarh in India. They have very monumental buildings. I think Brasilia particularly had no acceptance by the public whatsoever. It was off away from all population centers. The architecture was monumental and almost arrogant, and the people built squatter settlements all around it. This kind of thing could happen here. I think the 5 proposals, the city, the governmental buildings themselves are thought to be of the people rather than at the people.
Let's take a look at those 5 proposals. First, the one by Heinrich Bull and Associates.
Everyone said that it shouldn't be like the traditional capital with the gold dome. With traditional architecture. Several did what we did, that is to make a more public space with the idea that the public should be able to see their government in action. And that was the basis of our architectural statement. And that public space was a place for people to have fun as well as be adjacent to the judiciary and legislature.
The second team, Friedberg and Partners, Benjamin Thompson and Associates, said that the new capital city should be a romantic city, and one obviously with dignity. They clustered their city around a group of lakes with an enclosed winter garden, which would be the lobby and gathering center for the whole town. Each team was given $16,000 to do the planning, but they all spent 2 to 5 times that executing their designs. The third team, Lane, Knorr, and Plunkett, was one of two Alaskan firms chosen. Their space age design had the capital as the core, with residential areas radiating like spokes from it, all connected by covered walkways surrounded by open wilderness. Maynard, NBBJ Alaska of Anchorage, chose to concentrate the city along the south shore of Deception Creek and to spread state offices around the periphery of the city to minimize the massive effect of a group of government buildings. The crown jewel of Sasaki Associates' plan is a glass-enclosed public reception room that serves as the center of the city and the capital.
A capital center such as this is really many things to many people. It's both a place where Alaskans would live and work, and it's a formal arrival and a symbolic center for the state. It's a reception point for the many visitors who come to the state. And it's a focus for people in Alaska who would be coming here from outside of the new capital city. And it has to really respond to all of these and provide an answer to all the needs of all of these people. Our feeling is that the expression that we have here is unique and characteristic of Alaska.
The eventual design of the city may contain elements of all five of these plans, but the commission chose one firm to design the master plan, Bullfield, Volkman, and Stockwell.
It's a tremendous challenge, and it's one that really ought to involve many, many different people in a somewhat free association, but all going to the same goal. And the purpose of the master plan really is to get some basic organization to that so it doesn't get to be the same kind of patchwork quilt that Anchorage is.
The design of the city is only one part of the commission's work. Figuring out how much it costs and how to pay for it is critical. Charles Belke, chairman of the commission.
Alaskans right now are much more interested and much more concerned with the costs of the capital move than they are with the actual physical plans. But 50 years from now, if the capital's moved, the physical plans will be what will be important and people will have forgotten what the cost is.
In order to get the capital moving as quickly as possible, the commission is considering setting up an independent development corporation to build the city. It would be able to sidestep state hire and contract bidding rules. But some of the commissioners, including Belke, see some danger in the plan, especially when it comes to letting millions of dollars of construction contracts.
Well, there are a lot of dangers in such a corporation, yes. The main danger that I see is the possibility of doing contracting outside of normal bidding processes.
Deciding the cost of the move is also a complicated chore. Every aspect must be considered. Details like choosing between above-ground or underground parking can mean as much as $40 million difference in the final cost. Cost is where politics enters the commission.
Really what it boils down to is that those who are opposed to the capital move would really like us to identify every possible cost, and this is difficult for us to do, but they're pressing this issue to try to find every possible cost that's associated with the capital move. I think this is fair. I don't think this is unfair at all. And of course, the other side of the fence perhaps would like us to ignore a few of these costs.
The delivery of the new city is dependent upon the passage of a bond of unknown size. Those who want to see the move aborted are hoping the price will stretch the state's overall bonding capacity so far that people won't vote for it. Sterling Gallagher, Commissioner of Revenue.
Anything that pushes the state's limit that really tells you about the worthiness of the project. And if we can't do it and do some of the other things we want to do in the state and without hurting our limit, I would recommend against it.
And will moving the capital push that limit?
I haven't seen their cost yet.
The specter of creating a stillborn city casts this shadow over those who are conceiving it. Jim Kroll, Public Relations Director for the Commission.
There's been a lot of excitement in the building of these designs, the thrill of creativity, and certainly goes way beyond what monetary rewards they had. But overall, there is a pall. There's this this dark cloud. Are we doing this just for laughs? Is this a charade? Because no one, even the time that the people had to select a place to put the building, knew if there'd be a city. And as we're building the plans for the city, we don't know there'll be a city either.
A closer look at those who question the costs and what, if anything, Juneau is doing to prepare itself for the move when Alaska Review continues.